Congressman Dr. John Fleming is joining us. Well, I guess it's good news. We've made the list.
What's that mean?
Of disaster areas.
Well, it means that we qualify for federal assistance. And so that's very important. You may recall last spring when we had flooding, there were certain areas that didn't meet the threshold. And as a result, didn't get the value to federal assistance and had to rely on the state, which, as you know, right now doesn't have enough money to cover its cost. So this is helpful to the state. It's certainly very helpful to the area. It's helpful to people who have homes that are damaged, who qualify for federal aid.
What does Jim Bob in Houghton, what can he expect to get from the federal government?
Well, it all depends on whether he has insurance, but in most cases he's required to have flood insurance if he has a mortgage. Typically a bank won't give you a loan on your home if it's in a designated floodplain unless you do have. But what really is helpful is think about all of the roads that have washed out. Think of all the huge damage that's occurred to the infrastructure. Whatever could happen, like bridges or levees, but none of which that I know of have been destroyed. But still, there's a lot of damage to roads. And now we get federal assistance to repair those. Otherwise, the county or the parish or the state would have to pay for that.
Dr. John, what's the time frame on that money coming in to help folks out? Is it normally... I mean, government's a big place, man. How long does it normally take?
Typically, things that have immediate requirements occur. You know, there'll be some flow of money, a small amount initially, and then after the assessments are completed, I believe a FEMA team is on the ground as we speak. They're expected to be anyway, but. Through the next few weeks and into the month, as everything is assessed and the cost and then bids for repair and all that, that money will begin to flow gradually increasing over time until the work is completed.
What the logistics? Red Cross goes out to homes to help. FEMA, typically you go to them and bring your documentation. Is that what you're expecting here?
Yes. Really, it's up to you to let people know how you're affected. And so whether you're a private homeowner or whether you are local officials in a parish or in a city, you've got to report that information. And certainly you can go to my office or call my office there in Shreveport, or you can reach out to the governor's office, and they can help you process that, get you linked up with the right person. There's likely to be an office to open up, a temporary FEMA office to open up, so you can go directly to them. So, and I'm sure you can contact the sheriff's offices in both Bossier and Shreveport and surrounding parishes like DeSoto and Webster, and they can direct you as well. So all it takes is just one phone call, and you're in the loop.
Let me ask you, Robert asked you about timing on when the money would come in. I'm under the impression that about $1 million that Bossier spent from the summer floods of last year, they have yet to receive. It's just a lengthy process to pay for some of the government expenses?
Well, of course, you know that Washington works at light speed, don't you?
Right.
In that specific case, we could certainly find out. I don't know what the holdup is. Typically, it's just adequate documentation. Once you submit it, they have more questions, so you have to answer those. You go back and forth. If it's a problem, if we think that it's hung up in the bureaucracy, then again, they need to let us know, and we're happy to act on that.
Dr. John, going in a little bit of a big bit of a different direction, we heard on Fox News Top of the Hour that the president will announce his Supreme Court nominee later this morning. Other than the fact it will be someone who is probably not conservative, Is any rumors, anything you're hearing, like in the coat room of the House of Representatives?
Well, I met personally with Leader McConnell, and I've spoken with a number of senators since then, and they all tell me there's not going to be a single meeting with a nominee. There's not going to be a hearing about a nominee. There's not going to be any bills moved. And for certain, there will not be a confirmation of any nominee by this president. So that's basically a dead letter. There's not going to be, the president can nominate all he wants, and he would be fulfilling his constitutional responsibility. But the Senate acts under its own time span, and it's not going to act, and it's that's a function of its separation of powers through the Constitution as well. So the bottom line here is that we're soon to have a new president. That president should get his or her choice of nominee, and that's the way it traditionally works. It's very rare that in the last year of a last term of a president that this process is completed.
Congressman John Fleming, thank you for your time this morning. We appreciate it.